What's going on, guys? Wanted to fire up the camera real quick and show you a project I just finished on the CNC router. Something I've been working on for a while now and I've been pretty excited about, and that's this new shop knife design. And it's gone through a couple of iterations already, several prototypes. I've used no small amount of material kind of to get to this point. And you might even say I wasted quite a bit. But, you know, each piece was just one step further to the finished product. And I just really wanted to make sure I had it right. So I decided to use micarta for all of them instead of like MDF or some other cheaper, more disposable material. As you've really got to see how the cutters are going to do and just what the final dimensions are going to look like. So here's what we have as far as the overall package. A nice, very tightly formed Kydex sheath that you could stick in a pocket. You probably figure some way to tie it to a belt if you really wanted to, but I really like this for hanging around the neck. It's nice and light. I don't have a weight on it just yet. I'll have to go put it on the scale, but it's very light. You almost forget it's there until you need it. And when you do need it, it just pulls out very nice and easily and is ready to go. So I'll show you that one more time. Clicks very nicely into the sheath and very easily pops right out and it's ready for use. Now, one thing to note, I did go ahead and make this to where you get just about as much of the blade as you can on these utility blades. I know most Stanley style knives or even a lot of the utility blade holders you're seeing today, you know, at the most they're going to give you about this much blade, maybe about half of the blade if you're lucky. And sometimes that's really just not enough. So I wanted to kind of maximize that cutting edge a little bit better than that, and got just about as much of it as I felt comfortable with without potentially compromising you know, the stability of the handle there. So you've got maybe about a quarter of an inch of the point behind the handle there, but certainly plenty of material in there that you can clamp this and not have to worry about it going anywhere. And it is a two-piece design. This is made from linen micarta, kind of a brown natural micarta. You can see some little lines milled in there for texture and aesthetics. A quarter inch lanyard hole, and you can see it's just about a full hand grip. It's probably more of a 3 to 3.5 finger grip in reality. And that is one nice feature about this lanyard hole. You could always add a little lanyard there if you want to kind of get that last finger, something to really grab onto. But as it is now, I've got large hands. There's plenty there to really get a good solid purchase on and really do some heavy cutting if needed. And that was first and foremost consideration. I did want a knife that you could use. I know there's a lot of really neat designs out there right now, many of them even with retractable blades or some kind of sliding mechanism. You know, those are all really neat and innovative, but at the end of the day, you're really not going to be able to do a whole lot of heavy cutting with those without risking the blade pulling out, or in some cases, you really don't have enough handle to begin with to really get some leverage on. So that was kind of one of my first considerations with this. It's just having something you could use for just about anything. And I did add a threaded insert for the main clamping screw, just so you could really crank down on that and not have to worry about it stripping out ever. Or if it did, you could remove that and just put a new one in. And then this side, it's threaded directly into the micarta, which I'm sure some people might get a little nervous about. But micarta is actually a very strong material, and it takes threads pretty readily. And, you know, you really got to crank down on this to strip these out. Not saying I couldn't. You know, I could easily strip it out if I really wanted to. But as far as, like, accidentally stripping it out, you know, you're not going to accidentally strip it out. Just as long as you snug this one down and then, you know, really snug that one down, this blade's never going to go anywhere. Now, to be honest, this screw probably isn't really even necessary. I probably could have just as easily just stuck a pin in there or, you know, not put anything in there. But it does add just a little bit of extra stability or strength to keep that blade from pulling out. And I'll go ahead and show you that. You know, say this gets loose somehow or you don't tighten it up all the way. You know, that blade's in there loose now, but it's still not going to pull out of there. You know, even if I kind of push the blade forward, there's no way that's accidentally going to fall out of there. Until I want it to come out, then I'll just back the screw all the way out. And again, you just have to loosen this screw a little bit. And blade pulls right out, ready to be flipped or changed as needed. And then to put the new one in, just line that notch up with the front hole. Push the screw in. Just barely snug it up there. It really doesn't take much, just to where it stops wiggling. And then you crank that main center screw down. And that's going to take more force than you'll be able to give it to pull that out of there. So that was a blade change. Just go over the screws there a little bit. And overall, I think it's just a pretty good looking little knife there. Very comfortable. It's heavily contoured. I milled a lot of curves and slots and things into this. Rounded over all the edges, all the corners. So, nice and comfortable. It's got some jimping there for the thumb, as well as on the backside here, just to give you a little extra purchase. But again, very comfortable and easy to really put some leverage into. And one added little bonus here, because of that extra length of blade stick out there, you've got plenty of clearance around this edge here. If you need to use this knife as a scraper, it makes really good tape or glue scraper, you know, on a flat surface. You can clean things up like that, you know, grease, adhesive, glue, what have you, tape. Just works really well for that. And then I'll show you, there's my maker's mark, my last name, Riley, engraved right into the clamp. So that's pretty much it, guys. I think I'm going to be offering a couple of these for sale. I plan on making several more. But keep an eye out on my Instagram. I'll add the info there. And as well as pricing and, you know, shipping details, things like that. If you guys are interested in one, like I said, keep an eye on Instagram. I'll put up a post probably not too long from now, giving you guys the details if you want to buy one. So there it is, guys. It's the Riley Shop Knife, and I think it'd be a nice little addition for getting work done around the shop. Thanks for watching.